Well, here we go, guys. Day four with an other beer from England. And this time, it is a dry hop. A double dry hops IPA. Now, I kind of like IPAs every now and then, but sometimes they're kind of disappointed. What I personally like is if they have what I call a bit of a bite. So I'm very curious. Of course, IPA is inspired by or based on Indian pale ale, I should say, is inspired by normal pale ale. It's just a bit more hoppy, because you know they wanted the beer to last longer, and dry hopping is a technique where they added even more hop to the beer after the beer was already cooled off. So during the yeasting, I guess a double dry hop means that they added even more. Yeah, the brewer is from a computer expert, John Hicklin, who just decided to go brewing, and now he's one of the best brewers in England. And yeah, we have a tropical double dry hopped IPA. Really interested in that, so let's go and give it a try, because you're probably sick of me talking about it. There we go. Pretty can, by the way. I liked it. Yeah. Kind of cool. Oh, you can really smell those tropical fruits. That's cool. And I smell a bit of the hop. Oh, nice and fruity. Like that. There's a little bit of a bite in the aftertaste, but not too much. Not me. Oh yeah, there's the bite. Perfect. Wonderful. I really like this one. Yeah. So yeah, this is Vocation special edition, a double dry hopped beer from John Hickling's brewer. I have no idea what the name of this brewer is. Vocation Brewery. So it's that's the name. It's Toucan Tropical. That's the name of the beer. I feel so hard at this. Oh well. Time for the box with D&D dices. And let's see what we have today. Oh. And broken off. Oh. Okay. It looks like a D20. The light is so bad to show this. It really looks like a D20, but it's a completely. I mean, it's a beautiful one. I have to give them that. It's not a D20 even. It's more. But it's a beautiful one. But it's unreadable, man. Like, I think I see a 7. I see a 4, maybe 1. plus minus an 11. Yeah, this is. Even though this D&D dice is a bit beautiful, I'll have to post a picture of it because it's not the most. Because in this light, you can't really see. There's too much details to the. Die. Yeah, no, I can't get it to be visible on the camera, but yeah, it's a bit too bad, but this die is not very readable, but beautiful. So yeah. Anyway, I've been rambling on way too long. I'm gonna put a picture of the die at the end of the video, I guess. And yeah, I'm gonna see you guys tomorrow with something new that I don't know yet. Bye. So yeah, here we have it, the D&D dice. That is, well, pretty beautiful, but I cannot read this die. Like, what is this? What is this? This is 7, I think. This is a finger one, but yeah, it's a bit too bad.